The Terry College is proud to present its 2012 Outstanding Young Alumni Award to Matt Stinchcomb.
It's my pleasure to welcome Matt Stinchcomb to the stage.
Sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
Yeah. I gotta gather myself after that entrance music. That's what happens. I was actually out of town when the Terry College asked, you know, what kind of theme music would you like to have? And so I let my wife choose. And I just said, just something that's fitting, something that reminds you of me. And after 12 years of marriage, I'm flattered, honey. This is a tremendous honor. I was somewhat surprised when I was notified that I was going to get this recognition. My birthday is June 3rd, I'm 34, and one of the qualifications for this distinction is that you be 35 years of age or younger. And so, effectively, I've taken longer than any other young alumni to earn this distinction. And so it's more of an endurance award for me, I think, than anything else. But the fact that it comes from this college, at an institution that we all love and I think admire in many, many ways, is an added incentive. It makes it all the more of a distinction that I hold in high regard. And I certainly appreciate the recognition by the nominating committee, et cetera. Brother Stewart indicated to me, we were visiting earlier, that he was gonna quote a couple of well-known folks. Now, whether he goes on and does that, I'm holding him to it now. But I panicked at that point because I didn't really have anything prepared in that regard. But I thought back to the first boss that I ever had. And it was somewhat unique in that it was John Gruden. And he was a man of many facial expressions, somewhat profane at times. But underneath all that, he was a philosopher. And at one point in time, he did point out that I spoke too much. If I ever closed my mouth, my butt would whistle, apparently. But something that I think was probably more relevant or appropriate, even for this type of gathering, was that he mentioned to me, he said, you know, Stinch, you know what potential is? You know what that means? And I'm usually terrified at this point. And I said, no, sir, I don't. He said, it means you hadn't done it yet. And that's part of what I think about and what the Terry College meant to me, means to me, and what it means to the students that are studying or in the tutelage of the faculty at the University of Georgia now, is that when you hear about Jessica Obbies or some of these other young, distinguished students that we have here in this room here tonight, the potential is potentially limitless. The problem is, of course, is translating that into actual achievement. And I think what makes this college so great is obviously it's a fantastic educational experience. The faculty is fantastic. But it's not just the classroom, it's your classmates that you are amongst every day in that setting. It's the relationships that you develop, and it's the ability that this college provides its students to take dreams and make them into a reality, to actually capitalize on that potential. And for that, I'm incredibly grateful. It has held me in very good stead many, many times. It's been a rudder for major decisions that I've had to make, and it's been a lifeboat when I've made poor decisions. So I am very grateful for that. Part of the qualifications, as it was described to me, was philanthropic work. One of the things that I appreciate the most about that is that you can't do it for yourself and you don't do it by yourself. And I am, my entire life, I've been a collaborator. I can't hit a baseball. I can't catch a baseball. I can't pitch. I can't hit a free throw. I require assistance. I'm an assistance sponge. If I walk into a gap, there are 12 people around me almost immediately. You should buy socks with that. You should belt that. They are constantly wanting to help me out. I'm a lost sheep. That's why I played offensive line. There's just five guys that you kind of glom together. But in philanthropy, you can't do anything on your own behalf, and it's very, very difficult to do it in and of yourself. I'm far from being a lone ranger in that regard. And I'm thankful for our charitable partners, for Children's Healthcare of Atlanta, for Georgia Transplant Foundation, for the University of Georgia's Clinic for Children with Disabilities, for the Children's Tumor Foundation. It's not only rewarding work, but it's a very endearing endeavor to be able to work with those people every day. And I'd be remiss if I did not recognize my brother, because he has been a part of everything that I've ever been able to participate in philanthropically, and has been an inspiration to me in a lot of ways and an encouragement to do even more. We usually have the same goal, we just have different ways of getting there. And the other person I'd like to recognize is my wife, Jenny. Now, she did go to Auburn, and that's a disclaimer, that's all. Because she has been the catalyst for me to make the transition from being a caveman football player into doing something more. And it has always been incredibly inspiring to me in that regard as well. Thank you so much this evening for these proceedings, for this ceremony, and for this recognition. Enjoy the rest of your night. Enjoy Brother's philosophical references. And thank you for this recognition. Good evening.